From prenatal vitamins to maternal vaccines, expectant moms want the best for their unborn babies. But sometimes what mothers pass on to their babies can, through no fault of their own, cause serious health issues. This can be the case with antibodies, which are proteins produced by the immune system to help the body fight bacteria and viruses. One example is a rare blood disorder that causes mom's antibodies to destroy the baby's red blood cells. It's called hemolytic disease of the fetus and newborn, which can cause severe anemia and jaundice. The disease can occur when the pregnant mother's blood and her baby's blood are incompatible with each other. Another example is when a baby's blood platelets are not compatible with the mother's. When this happens, mom's immune system may respond to her baby's unfamiliar platelets as if they were attacking her, sending harmful antibodies across the placenta and causing fetal neonatal alloimmune thrombocytopenia, or extremely low platelet counts in her baby. Sometimes, harmful antibodies transferred to unborn babies have nothing to do with compatibility, but instead result from their mother's own immune system. This is the case with congenital heart block. If the mother has an autoimmune condition, such as lupus or Sjogren's syndrome, her body may create antibodies that attack her child's heart as it develops in the womb. The good news is that these conditions are rare, and new, innovative therapies are being developed that could be life-saving for babies. Meanwhile, expectant mothers can take proactive steps to reduce their baby's risk. Women can consult with their obstetric care provider about testing to identify potential blood type incompatibilities and other risk factors. All mothers want what's best for their babies. Through greater awareness, heightened vigilance, and improved testing and treatment options, babies have a better chance of healthy growth and development before birth and a healthy childhood. Learn more at infanthealth.org.